We have taken over. This is Entertainment, Arts, and Sports Law Society. My name is TJ Purcell. I am a 3L and Vice President. We have taken over the Instagram today. So here at Planet Fitness, been here about a little over an hour, early start, get the day going. Looking forward to sharing more with what we do. And I'm gonna tee it up to our president, Gabrielle Wright. Looking forward to sharing more with what we do, ask questions. We're here to give the people what they want. Mask up, I'm gonna go enjoy this massage chair and I'll be back on later today. Gab, it's up to you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Gabrielle Wright. Like TJ said, I'm the president of the Entertainment Arts and Sports Law Society. And today, along with TJ and another individual, Hayes, who you'll meet after me, we're going to be taking over the Instagram. We're excited to tell everyone what the Entertainment Arts and Sports Law Society is all about, give you some information of how to get involved, what we do throughout the year, any interesting things, and what the Entertainment Arts and Sports Law Society has done for us. So come along on our journey today. I'm going to get my morning coffee because I am tired. But we're excited for today, so keep tuning in.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Hayes Rule, and I am a 2L here at Florida State University College of Law. I'm also the secretary of EASL. And before law school, I was a college golfer at Mercer University. I was a sports journalist both in high school and in college, so sports have played a pretty major role in my life. So after law school, I intend to go into corporate law and then hopefully have a little bit of work in the sports industry as well. So sports law is something that is a bit of a niche industry. A whole lot of people don't know really what sports law is, and so hopefully today we will educate you a little bit about the industry, what roles you might be taking part of if you go into that industry. So follow along today and please ask us any questions and we'll be happy to help out.
Hi everyone. So you may be wondering what EASL is. So we are a collective body of law students who are interested in the intersectionality of law with entertainment, arts, and sports law. So essentially we get together throughout the semester and host meetings. So these meetings can be with attorneys who are a part of entertainment law, whether they be doing intellectual property work or individuals who work in the sports law arena as an agent or working for in-house at a team. So these individuals can span a whole host of different jobs, and so we really try our hardest to get our members exposed to as many opportunities and individuals as possible. So within EASL, we have our executive board. I'm president, TJ is the vice. So we also have a vice president, a secretary, those two who you met already. We also have a treasurer and two competition chairs. So we're going to be talking a lot more of the competitions that we are a part of. But these two individuals spearhead the planning and the execution of these competitions. Additionally, we have a 1L representative who is essentially the voice of EASL to the 1L class. 1L is a hard year, so having someone who is a liaison really helps bridge the gap between our organization and that class. Additionally, I have been working with other presidents of EASL's around Florida, and we plan to have a bigger role with the Florida Bar moving forward. So right now with COVID, we are having all of our meetings online over Zoom. We hope to be moving back to in person as soon as we can, but that's something that is going to be based on all the health precautions and everything we can take to make sure everyone is safe and healthy. That's the number one priority now. So post-COVID, we will be having meetings in person and get back to what pre-COVID looks like. Additionally, if you guys have any questions, I'm going to drop a question box, and please feel free to ask anything that you're interested in, whether it be EASL particular or about law school. We're really here to help you guys. So
we are back from, that was my co-counsel. We are back from entertainment law class, and I'm going to talk with you now more about the Major League Baseball competition that Gabrielle just mentioned. I'm part of the team. We use actual baseball players' data. We arbitrate contracts just as they would normally do, negotiating their contracts, because baseball has a different way how they do contracts. And so this gives you some behind the scenes inner workings to how the contracts work. We are in a competition that we'll have next week with law schools across the nation. We have actual general managers, judges, scouts that will judge our actual arbitration. We use exhibits, we use briefs, and it's a really good experience.
Hi everyone, I'm back to talk a little bit about the NFL contract negotiation competition that EASL is a part of each year. So I've been on the team for 3 years now. We have two teams currently, and we are planning on competing at the end of the month. So what it is essentially we get one player to start off with, and we write a brief about that individual and the contract that they should receive. So this year we received Cam Newton as the player that we have to write a brief on. So we compare them. We compared Cam Newton to other quarterbacks in the league and looked at their contracts to see the contract that Cam should get. And then for the competition itself, the negotiations, we receive three players, and we are told either we are representing the player or representing the team. And at that point also, we receive the different contract structures that we may want to implement for that contract. So whether it be a guaranteed signing bonus or receive a certain amount of money in their P5, this is something that we're told. And so we walk into the negotiation room and negotiate with the other team to get to a contract that is amenable for both sides. Something that TJ didn't touch on is how do you join one of these teams? So each fall we have a interest meeting that 1Ls, 2Ls, and 3Ls all can attend and essentially say that they want to be a part of one of the teams, and then we have a write-on competition. So just like how we have to write a brief for the NFL contract negotiation competition, individuals who want to be a part of the team also have to write on to the team, and so they write a brief, the exact same one we would write.
All right, I am back showing up for my shift at the library. As you can see, the law lot's pretty empty. So most of us do have other jobs that we do besides EASL stuff, because you know, we're trying to be lawyers. We're trying to get
what's good guys.
Hey, give me 1 second. We got some people on campus. You know, we just like to have fun, but you know, we're trying to be lawyers. We're trying to get jobs, trying to make money. So walking up here, mask up, be safe. Reminder, please be sure to mask up, ask questions. We're here all day. We're here for the takeover. So allow us to take over. Talk to you guys soon.
Hey everybody, I am back talking to you about sports law. So what is sports law? Like I mentioned earlier, it's a little bit of a niche industry, mainly in the sense that really you could apply almost any area of the law to the sports industry, and then you would be called a sports lawyer. So for example, you could do criminal defense work for professional athletes who get in trouble, and a lot of people would look at you as a sports lawyer. You could do intellectual property work where you are helping develop athletes' brands through trademarks and things like that. You could do labor and employment work. You know, a lot of these athletes, well, they're employees, so there usually end up being employment issues with teams or leagues. Or again, on that flip side, you could do the labor work where you're working with the labor unions and negotiating the collective bargaining agreements with the leagues. You could also do corporate governance work or do the corporate transactions for the leagues or the teams, really, because again, these are corporations, just large corporations. So, you know, that's just a small sampling of really the things that you could potentially do in sports. Another big one potentially, you know, is working in-house for different teams or different leagues. So really, you know, whatever area of law that you find personally enjoyable, there's going to be a way for you to apply it to the sports industry if you really put yourself out there and try to do so. You know, most naturally, maybe, you know, one of the things, like, for example, if you wanted to go in-house, at that point, you're wanting to develop a lot of different skill sets, mainly probably with more transactional work, with contracts, really the same kind of experience you would get in-house with just a typical business. We have to look at these sports entities as corporations. And then also, again, you could be an agent. I think that's one thing that a lot of people think about sports law, and they think that's what you want to do. And so if you're being an agent, you know, you're kind of utilizing your legal skills, but not really practicing law. Again, you're kind of negotiating those contracts, not necessarily drafting them, maybe helping draft them, but just using a lot of the legal skills that you might learn in law school and applying it to sports. So as far as Florida State goes, you know, it offers a couple of externships for law students, mainly, you know, the 1Ls and 2Ls. Specifically, we work with NASCAR. I know we have some alumni who are in NASCAR. We also have an externship with the United Soccer League in Tampa. And we also have some alumni in the NFLPA, as well as the Tampa Bay Lightning. Those externships specifically are going to give you a really good inside look as to what it would be like to be an in-house counsel in a sports league or for a sports team. And again, really, you're just kind of treating it as if it were any other business. Let's say you were at Amazon or working, you know, for Publix in-house. A lot of the stuff is going to be very similar as far as the legal skills that you have to know. You know, obviously the industry is going to be a little bit different, and it's probably good for you to know about sports. Like, you don't necessarily have to be a sports expert to go work in-house in a sports team, but you should probably know at least enough about what's going on with the team to be able to just have that business background knowledge that will help you, you know, make those decisions as you're working in-house. But, you know, that's just one option potentially for you. Another option really is going and working in a law firm to start out in your career, potentially in big law. So a lot of people will start in a big law firm, maybe doing just kind of general business work, corporate work, transactional work. You could even do litigation. Again, really the opportunities are limitless. And then they may potentially go in-house after starting in your law firm for a couple years. I know that is typically a popular route for a lot of people, and one that I've seen to be fairly successful. So, you know, that gives you the opportunity, again, either go in-house, or even if you decide to make partner or end up staying in the firm, you could just work with sports companies as outside counsel. So the companies would come to you, and you would do whatever they need you to do, whether it be a lawsuit or something else. So let's say you're working in a law firm and you've developed a relationship with a sports team, then they might call on you for your expertise. Let's say if you're a personal injury attorney, maybe they need your help defending a case, or if there's an employment issue or a contract dispute that needs litigating, they'll probably call upon you. And so again, that's another way where you're working as an attorney, just an everyday attorney, but you have clients who are in the sports industry. And again, that's another fairly common route for people to go down. But as far as law school goes, if you're wanting like opportunities in law schools, really the best hands-on stuff is going to be through an organization like EASL, who sends students to competitions like Gabby and TJ have already discussed. Really in the law, it's good as a law student if you're able to get that hands-on practical experience. The competitions really range from NFL to MLB. I know there's even an NBA competition, so you know, get involved with that kind of stuff if you can, if you have the time to. That's just one of those great options that you have as a law student to kind of dip your toes into the sports industry and see if it's something that you enjoy. I would also really suggest writing and kind of developing your own brand in that way. I think if you're really wanting to get into sports, you need to show not only that you have an expertise in the law, I mean, that's really the most important thing, and the thing you should primarily be focusing on is becoming the best attorney you can be, but also showing that you understand the industry as well. So if you can write about some sort of legal development going on in sports, let's just call it, you know, NIL within college sports right now, that's going to give you a leg up. And then finally, one of the things that's great about Florida State is that the state of Florida is a very great state for sports. There's a lot of professional sports teams all over the state of Florida. There's a lot of kind of minor league teams. There's a lot of professional or a lot of collegiate university teams. Really almost any kind of sport that you can think of or any kind of level of sport, they've probably at least got a team or some kind of headquarters or something in the state of Florida. So, you know, attorneys who are working in firms oftentimes have clients in sports, or, you know, it's easy to sort of network and just meet the counsels of those teams just by living and being in Florida. So Florida State, not only do they offer an EASL like us, they offer sports and entertainment classes, but also sort of give you a leg up on some of those other law students who are in the state of Florida. Now, that's just sort of the gist of what sports law is, but I could talk a lot more about it. So if you have any questions, please feel free to use the question box that Gabby put up earlier in the story. Feel free to DM us, whatever it may be. I'm happy to help as much as I can. And then now I know that Gabby is gonna follow me up and talk a little bit about the entertainment and arts side of EASL.
So Hayes previously talked about opportunities for sports law, and now I'm gonna talk a little about opportunities for entertainment law. There are so many different opportunities afforded to EASL members and the student body alike for entertainment law to learn and to grow. So whether that be networking or possibly there's certain writing opportunities, like there's one that deals with the Grammys, which is very interesting, which you talk about some sort of legal issue that's affecting the music industry. Things like that that allow you to get in front of a national audience is something that we really pride ourselves on giving our members the benefit of. So we received a question about what can 1Ls do during their first year to help with their future career in entertainment or sports law. And one thing I would say from the offset is to focus on your first year classes. They are so important, and understanding the basic nuances of certain classes, especially contract law, is something that I think is very important for 1Ls, especially those who are going into entertainment and sports law. Get involved with EASL. That's a great way. Network with any individual that we have at a lunch meeting or any other meeting that we have. Be sure to possibly join one of our competition teams and see if you can write onto one of those. Another thing that you can do is for your 1L summer, intern at whether it be an agency. So you can work at a firm who deals with entertainment law. You can maybe even work for a sports team. These are all opportunities that can be afforded to you as long as you avail yourself of them and network and all that. I guess the biggest thing besides focusing on your first year courses as well is getting yourself out there and networking with the right people. This industry is really about who you know, and putting yourself in front of them is the biggest hurdle that a lot of people will face.
Just want to say it's been a pleasure sharing more of Entertainment Arts and Sports Law Society with all of you guys today. Don't tell them that we took over. Our little secret. Hopefully you learned some more about us today. Once again, I'm TJ. I'm the Vice President of Entertainment Arts and Sports Law Society. It's been a pleasure sharing us today. If you have any questions, just feel free to get in contact with us. We want to see all of you surviving and thriving. Start off 2021, your best year yet. And go Noles.
Hi everyone, it's been so fun taking over FSU College of Law's Instagram today. I hope everyone had a great day, and for all the future 1Ls or anyone at the law school, if you have any questions about EASL or about law school in general, feel free to reach out to me. I'll leave my email and my Instagram handle on this video. So I hope everyone has a great year.